And we just want to talk about the fact that it was last Sunday we celebrated Italian Day at the Ontario Place, and it was a huge success. We had over 42,000 people and everybody standing up and wanting to be counted as fiercely Canadian, mighty proud of their Italian heritage. It was a stupendous, fantastic success. And one of the big features of our Italian Day was the fact that we picked the Miss Chin Italia for the 1983. And I have with me the lovely little signorina, Signorina Rosa Arena, who won the first prize. Here she is, ladies and gentlemen, Rosa Arena, Miss Chin Italia 1983. She's a very lovely girl and was born and raised in Toronto. Is that right, Rosa?
Yes.
Where were you born in Toronto? Etobicoke, North York, College?
I'm not very sure. I think it was North York.
North York, okay. All right. Do you feel very proud or nervous,
yes,
excited?
all of them all together. It was a very exciting experience, and everyone just was so very wonderful, very kind, and just something very different for me.
Is this the first time you've ever won a beauty contest?
Yes, first time.
First time you've ever entered?
Ever entered, ever won, yes.
That's nice, that's very nice. Did you have problems with your parents when you suggested to them that you entered the contest?
No, they were very supportive.
So they were very supportive, yes. And encouraged you, is that correct?
Yes.
Oh, that's nice. Tell me, do you come from a large family, Rosa?
No, there's just my parents and I have a little brother.
Oh, you have a little brother,
yes.
So there's just two of you? And tell me, your parents came from what part of Italy?
La Basilicata, provincia di Potenza.
Potenza, Basilicata, I see.
Si.
And I know that you're proud of your heritage. Are you doing anything about the heritage? Are you going to school to learn to speak a little of Italian? Or are you listening to Chin so that you can pick up Italian? What are you doing to really bring forth your roots and culture besides going to school here? Mm-hmm. Do you go to school, as a matter of fact?
Yes, I do go to school. Unfortunately, they don't offer the Italian course at the school where I go to.
What school is that?
Holy Name of Mary High School.
I see.
But I listen to Chin very frequently so that I could pick up on certain little things. And
I see.
I love the music and everything about Chin, so that's what I'm doing to help myself in that way.
Are you going to join our Chin fan club?
Yes, for sure.
Right then, and you're going to be at our Chin Fan Club motor cruise on the Love Boat.
I wouldn't miss it, yes.
Don't forget, and the date is Sunday, August 21st.
Okay.
All right, Rosa Arena, Miss Chin Italia of 1983, Ontario Place last Sunday. And those of you out there that want to see more about our Italian Day of last Sunday, stay tuned because we've got the beautiful videotape and you will see the lovely Signorina Rosa Arena being crowned the Queen of Ontario Place last Sunday as Miss Chin Italia 1983. We'll be right back. Such a fantastic success last Sunday at the Festival della Canzone Italiana, Italian Day, the Beauty Contest, and the Song Festival. And I'd like to say that the winning song, The Calm Before the Storm, sung by The Phase Two and written by Frank Salerno and Sergio Tarantino, it spells out the fact that we've got lots of talent here of Italian origin, and we just have to help them and encourage them to show their talents to the world, and that's what we did last Sunday. We had 26 contestants, and out of the 26, we had originally about 100. So next year, we hope to perhaps maybe hear the rest of them, and or maybe later on in the year. But we could only pick 26. That doesn't mean that they were the 26 best. It's just the 26 we picked by a jury, and they thought that they should be heard first, and we'll have other festivals. But there are 26 original songs written by Canadians of Italian origin and performed by Canadians of Italian origin at Ontario Place last Sunday. And now we'd like to go to a documentary and show you what was happening at the Italian Day last Sunday, and we want to begin right now.
Early morning, the people are just pouring in to the Ontario Place. There's the accordion player who was greeting everybody, playing all the beautiful Italian tunes, and there's the Canadian flag alongside with the Italian flag. There's a group going over to the bandstand in the chin boat, and my daughter Danina is the pilot, and there's some of the scenes that we saw as we were going along the canal in the boat. There's the Father Polo, who was celebrating the Mass, the Rock Mass, out in the open and at the west end of Ontario Place at the bandstand. And there the early morning crowd that arrived for the Mass. And we do want to thank Padre Polo, who was gracious enough to come early Sunday morning to celebrate Mass at the Ontario Place and give us strength and blessing for the rest of the day. And certainly we do want to thank Padre Polo, and there are the people who are taking communion early Sunday morning, so they don't miss the communion and Mass by having attended our Ontario Place. There's a couple who won a prize for having the best costumes, red, white, and green, of course. There's the crowd, there's a sign spelling out who sponsored our Italian Day, Carling O'Keefe, and we do thank them very, very graciously. There's Brunella, who is the singer, lead singer in one of the groups, the Moonlight Orchestra, who you will see tonight at the Earls Court Park in a concert that we'll be doing there with Rino Iannone and Enzo Guzman, the Moonlight Orchestra. There's a potato sack races, and very exciting and funny and enjoyable, and each one was given a chin t-shirt. There are more winners of the costumes at the Italian Day at the picnic. There's the sack races, and these potato sack races are very, very popular with the young people, and we thought we'd do quite a few. And then the older guys got in there. Papa's got in there. Look at this guy. Hey, boy, he looks like a little greyhound. Anyway, that was all at the bandstand. This is the west end part of the Ontario Place. There's Rino Iannone, who did a super job in emceeing all the contests at the west end bandstand. There's a group from Guelph and Kingston. This is the Kingston group of children singing all the folk songs of Italy. No, this is Zecchino d'Oro of Hamilton. Yes, Zecchino d'Oro of Hamilton. Then we have the Kingston group later on. That was Zecchino d'Oro from Hamilton. And there are the crowds. And next we go to the watermelon eating contest. Yeah, boy, this was really funny. I'm telling you, if you want to see something funny, remember this is not a cultural thing. This is a fun thing. This is what the picnic was all about. It was something to make people laugh and enjoy. And they're living in a country where you can enjoy yourself and stand up and be counted. And this is why we celebrated Italian Day in Canada. Imagine, only in Canada can you celebrate another culture. And this is what we're doing here. We're having a lot of fun, not just the culture, but we're enjoying ourselves. These are kids who are eating watermelon for prizes, and they're enjoying themselves. And I'm sure that they're also good at school, and they go to church and do what their mothers and fathers tell them to do. But that particular day last Sunday, they're out to have a lot of fun. And they got themselves a free t-shirt, a chin t-shirt, and they got hats, and they've got prizes, and they enjoyed themselves. There's another contest. This is called the Chow Cream Eating Contest. It's sort of an Italian peanut butter. It's a creamy peanut butter that spreads very easily on wafers and is a delight to taste, and it comes from Italy, and it's very popular with the Italian children. And there's one lad who has eaten a whole jar and three wafers of chow cream peanut butter. There's a healthy little boy. There's another picture of the crowds, the many thousands that attend. Remember that we had over 42,000 attend this Italian Day last Sunday at the Ontario Place. And this is the chicory eating contest. This is a dandelion green eating contest, and we have a lot of fun with this talk about dandelions. Dandelions are green, something like spinach, and very healthy for you, full of iron, and it comes for free. You can pick them anywhere along the 401 or the 404 or anywhere at all in some in the fields up in North York or up in Etobicoke Way, wherever. I used to go for chicory just north of St. Clair as a little boy and get 25 cents for a whole sack. And there's the Lombardi Cup for the annual chicory eating contest. These are people in the crowds. There's a little boy eating a lot of chicory, and he's going to grow up to be healthy and wealthy and wise because he's full of iron. And there's one of the winners, and he's a healthy-looking boy. There's the showboat. It was going up and down the channel, and there's my daughter, Danina, and Frank Benvenuti of Carling O'Keefe, the voice of Carling O'Keefe in the Italian community. There's Catherine, and what else? Oh, we've got many other things. But best of all, we want to say that we enjoyed ourselves immensely, and right after this, we're coming back for more of the Italian Day at Ontario Place.
Grazie signori, benvenuti all'Italian Day, la giornata italiana, la nostra giornata. Un applauso a voi signori.
There's a picture that I like very much, everybody wanting a Canadian flag so they can wave the Italian flag the Canadian flag at Italian Day, because they're fiercely Canadian, mighty proud of their heritage. There's a fellow dressed in green trousers, white jacket, and red and white green tie and a green handkerchief, very proud of his heritage, and happens to be yours truly, speaking in the best Italian he can muster.
E tutta ridere con te, e quando piangi tu piangi solo. Medaglia! Viva, viva!
All'Italia! There's a personable Enrico Farina. This is Maurizio Peluso, a young lad who was one of the runners-up in our picnic, international picnic bodybuilding contest. And he was a guest at our Italian Day, sponsored by Carling O'Keefe. And as you can see, 16 years old, he's built himself quite a body. And I'm sure he eats chigori. There's my son, Lenny, and I'm giving thanks to Lenny for the beautiful production job he was doing and has done. My son is very close to us, and
I want you all to know that I wouldn't work for any other man than this guy.
There's Rosarena, who not Rosarena, I'm sorry, that's Anna Montalban. There's Miss Chin Bikini 83, Jennifer Scott. She was a guest. There's Franco Valli, one of our senior announcers, one of the contestants in the beauty contest, another. We had 16 beautiful gals, there's another. The first one was Giuseppina Barreri, the second one was Sarina Ferrara, then Teresa Catalano, then Tiziana Abate, then we had Al Palladini and Romano Mazzucco, judges on the screen. There's the young lady Mariana Santa Maria, Emanuela Rossi, and you've seen Rosa Rena, Patrizia Ranoni,
Toscana, molto divertente partecipare al concorso.
Lucy Zorlo, Cristina Aoka, Dina Di Cotis, Isabella Fiori, not necessarily in that order, ladies and gentlemen, because they walk on pretty fast. There's a picture of the judges. And this lovely lady, Eva Piantoni, and Silvia Breghina, and then Maria Iocco, Kay Areganello, all beautiful girls, each and every one of them. There's Remo Marinucci. Who sang Granada.
This is prize number 3. That means Piantoni, number 13. Patrizia Leone, Jennifer Scott, Miss Chinby, Rosa Rena, Rosa Rena, Rosa Rena.
There's Rosa Rena, Miss Chin Italia, 1983, being crowned by yours truly. Beautiful fur by designed by Chantel Furs, worth $3,200.
Lovely lady tonight.
42,000 people agreed with the decision.